Hi, this is Tony Mormino with Insight Partners, and welcome to the Engineers HVAC Podcast, where we work to give back to the engineering community by sharing our HVAC application and design experience. In this episode, I'm going to talk about what it means to be a sales engineer in the HVAC industry. I hope that you enjoy it. Okay, welcome to our podcast. Again, Tony Mormino with Insight Partners. I'm the Technical Sales and Marketing Director here, and I'm excited about this solo podcast today. And I'm going to talk a little bit about what is a sales engineer and what that means to be one in the HVAC community. Now, I'm going to totally do this with some minor notes in front of me. You are going to get the unedited version of this, so there'll be a lot of ums. You might hear a cough or sneeze here and there, but that's the way I'm going to roll with it today, and I hope that's okay. We're not going to do a lot of editing. If you're watching this on video, you're going to see me reading a lot of notes, looking at the camera, looking off into weird places, but anyway, I hope that you find value in this regardless. So, sales engineer, account executive, two terms we use interchangeably in the HVAC world. And basically what that is a person who sells, at least in our industry, a person who sells air conditioning equipment. Okay. You're a technical sales guy. Technical sales is also a term that's used sometimes. It really is used more in different markets, I believe. But it's basically a person who sells technical equipment, sells it, supports it, helps select it, helps troubleshoot it, things along that nature. And I'm pretty excited about doing this. So I'm doing this episode because I know when I was graduating college, so I graduated University of Florida in 1997 with an engineering degree. I always felt this draw towards going into sales. I don't really know why. That's just the way I felt. And I could find very little information out there at the time. Now, I'm going to date myself a little bit, but in 1997, we had this new thing called the World Wide Web. And there wasn't a lot of information out there on the web, as we used to say. Even getting on there was a pain. You know, if you had roommates and they were on the phone, man, you weren't dialing up to the server. So very little information. And I noticed today, if I Google HVAC sales engineer, there's very little information today. So I thought I'd do this podcast, share my experience with that as a career, and hopefully this will help somebody. So like I was saying, I was sitting there about to graduate, talking to my guidance counselor at University of Florida. And I said, hey, what other jobs are there besides manufacturing? I really, for some reason, want to look into going into sales. And just so happened, he hands me this flyer, and Train Air Conditioning was doing a seminar there that afternoon. And there was a gentleman named Art Fox who came in, and he was the sales manager for the Jacksonville Train office. And he talked a little bit about what it meant to be a sales engineer, what the career entailed. And I just fell in love with it. I was like, wow, that sounds great. That's what I want to do. So I ended up interviewing with Train. I ended up working for Art for the next 10 years at Train in Jacksonville. So that's kind of how I got my start into sales engineering. And even when I was starting, I was like, what do we actually do? Like, I couldn't understand what the job entailed. I'll get into the details in a minute. So a little bit more about my history. So I worked for Train for 10 years. So that would have been in 2007, I left Train and I went to work with a private rep firm at the time. It turned out to be Innovative HVAC Sales. That's what we ended up changing the name to. I went to work there with a couple friends of mine that were at Train with me. And I worked there for 10 years as a sales manager, part owner, and sales engineer as well. So I left there in, let's see, so this would have been 2017. I left Innovative. I had been in the industry for about 20 years. I was pretty burned out, to be honest with you, and needed a break. And my wife and I kind of felt like we wanted to move. We wanted to experience a different part of the country in a different climate. So the plan we came up with was to sell everything we owned, buy an RV, load up the kids and the dog, and off we went. So it was really cool. It was a really neat time. Had everything we owned behind us, behind our pickup truck in the fifth wheel. And we drove around for about a year, and it's just an amazing experience. It was a blast. And if you ever have a desire to do that and can make that happen, it was really cool. I really recommend it. So anyway, so back to reality, after about a year of that, we ended up parking in Asheville here, which is where I'm at now, close to Asheville. We bought a cabin and we live here now. And that's where I live and work. I got a job with Insight Partners as an account executive, which is what we call sales engineers here. And I think most industries, HVAC, are switching to account executive, I believe. Anyway, so I started as an account executive with Insight Partners, did that for about a year and a half. And then when COVID hit, I started doing some of the online stuff for Insight, some of the marketing, and the leadership team liked what I was doing and I enjoyed it. And they asked me to do it full time. And I said, heck yeah. So here we are today. So I'm now technically the technical sales and marketing director at Insight Partners. So that's just a little bit of my history and a little bit of why I'm doing this podcast here. So I'll talk next a little bit about the HVAC industry in general. Okay. So if you want to go into sales, there's basically two primary different ways you could do that. So some of the manufacturers, the big guys like Trane, Carrier, York, et cetera, they have factory owned shops. Most of them do, not all of them. And so in other words, when you go to work for one of those folks, you work for them in a certain city. Okay. The other way that manufacturers distribute HVAC products is through independent reps. So for example, Insight Partners, we're an HVAC rep firm. We're located in four states, Carolinas, Georgia, and Florida. We are an independent rep firm and we have agreements with specific lines to rep their products in specific territories. So that's the two. You work for the factory, direct for a factory, or you work for an independent rep. There's pros and cons to both. I personally have done both. I'm more of an independent rep firm guy. I'm not a big corporation guy, although there are a lot of benefits to working for them as well. You know, my advice would be to you, if you're new coming into this field out of college, try to get an internship somewhere. It's a great way to learn the difference between the two. And you may find you don't like doing this job at all. So that's a good thing to find out too, before you spend, you know, the next 10, 20, 100 years, however long doing this job. Just a little bit of advice there. A little bit about being a salesman as well. So when I was in college, I was almost embarrassed to say I was going into sales, just not for me personally, but there was such a stigma like against sales. I don't know why that is. I think I kind of had a little bit of that too, you know, growing up, the picture of the, you know, the not so honest used car salesman comes to mind and stuff like this. But I can tell you my experience being a engineer in the HVAC world on the sales side is 100% not like that. I mean, almost without exception, you know, there are some exceptions, but almost always the people I'm working with are extremely honest and extremely caring, and they want to do the right thing by their customer. You know, they want to be a trusted advisor, as we call it. And that's really like kind of how we were trained to be, because most of our customers, you might work in an area for 20 years and you'll have a core group of a set number of people where you're going to deal with for that 20 years. So you're in motivated, you know, not just financially, but ethically and professionally to do the right thing with these customers and make sure you're taking care of them through the good and through the bad. So the trusted advisor is kind of how I view this role. And it's an extremely important role too. It's not a, you know, a lot of the jobs we do, and I'll touch base on this in a minute, you know, are what we call mission critical. You could have hospitals, surgery centers, data centers, places that were, when things go down, bad things could happen. So it's really important, if you're going to do this, to take it seriously, make sure you're always honest, upfront, you get the right answers to your clients when they're asking you. And if you don't know something, I've always been told, say, you know what, I don't know. I'm not going to say that I do. I'm going to go find it. So then I'll go research that, find someone who does know, and bring the answer forward. That's a great way to take care of your clients and to build trust. So, and on the sale, back to the sales thing, I kind of veered off there for a minute. Anybody who has the desire can go into sales, can do sales. It's not dependent on your personality. And what I mean by that is some sales guys are more of the golfers, you know, want to go party and have dinners and stuff like that. There's a lot of friends I have in the business who are like that, and that's great. That works for them. They're extremely successful, extremely happy. That's not really my thing. I'm not really a taking you golfing, going to have beers kind of guy. I'm more of a technical sales guy. In other words, I want to come in and do a presentation and teach your new guys about psychometrics, I'm the boring guy. Let's just put it like I want to do it more through education. I don't mind. I love having dinners with people too, but that's just not my driving force. Is more to build a relationship technically in that manner. So, and they equate, like, if you equate that to comedians, right? Like, there's a lot of successful comedians that have varying personalities. So one comedian might be really dry and really quiet, and but extremely successful and extremely funny. Other comedians are not that way, and they're extremely successful and extremely funny. So sales is kind of the same way. You can have any personality and do well in sales if your primary focus is to take care of the customer, to serve them, and make sure you're making them more successful with their owners, et cetera. Okay, so that's enough about that. So the building process in general, here's kind of how it flows and how HVAC fits into the building process and how your role as a sales engineer or account executive would fit into that building process. So you have an owner, a guy, a gal who wants to build a building, right? It could be a government building, it could be a municipality, a city thing, or it can be a hospital, or it could be a manufacturing facility, or it could be, you know, inside partners might want to build a warehouse or something like that. So any of these people build a building, one of the first things you do is hire an architect who designs the building. I'll just a side note, there are various ways this is done, but this is a general way. So you hire an architect, the architect hires, among other people, a mechanical engineering firm. That mechanical engineering firm will lay out or design the mechanical systems, one of them being HVAC, heating, ventilating, and air conditioning, okay? So a situation might go like this. Mechanical engineer, Joe Smith calls me. Hey, Tony, I got this hospital job. Can we talk about some options? Here's three options I want to look at. And I said, great, let's talk about it. So he might ask me for three different HVAC options. Let's say one's chill water, one's DX, one's VRF, something like that. DX rooftop units and then VRF. And then I would lay that out with him, the pros and cons of each, in my opinion, in hospital applications, and then the budget numbers, et cetera, and so forth. He would take that information to the owner. They would mull it over. He might come back to me. We might do three or four iterations like that. That's the first, you know, involvement of a sales engineer or account executive in an HVAC job. Okay. So let's say they decide on a system. Let's say it's system B that I presented, and he needs help designing it. So I would select that equipment. I would send him the weights, the dimensions, the CAD drawings, electrical, et cetera. He put that on his prints. Boom, he's done. He signs the prints. The prints go out for permitting, and then the prints go to mechanical contractors' offices. And again, there's like a million different ways this happens, but this is a general way. The mechanical contractor gets the prints, sees the equipment on there. He calls me, hopefully for a price, and he calls my competitors for a price. The job bids. He evaluates the bids if he gets the job, and he chooses a vendor. Hopefully that vendor is me. If I've done my job well and I have a good relationship with the contractor, he feels like I'm the best fit, et cetera. He chooses me for the job. Okay. So I got the purchase order for the job. Now the fun starts. You know, we say that now the hard work starts. Right now I have to make sure I submit the equipment properly. I have to make sure that I order the equipment properly. I have to make sure it arrives on time, and I have to make sure it gets started up in time. And then I have to support the equipment after the fact. You know, I'm still, you know, after 25 years in the business, I'm still looking for that perfect piece of air conditioning equipment to sell that has zero problems, and it does not exist, let me tell you. So you're going to have problems. I was told early on in this industry that the way you handle the problems will, you know, reveal your true character. It'll separate you from the rest of the guys, because anybody could be a good sales guy and take care of people when things are well. It's when the, you know, when the problems go on, when the unit's down, it's a lab, people are screaming at the contractor, you know, the engineer's calling you, hey man, can you help me get this? You got to get in the car and go help them. You know, that's kind of how it works if you care about this job and care about your customers. Okay. And then you support that equipment through the rest of the equipment's life. And then you do it all over again. Hopefully the next day someone else calls you. So you have hopefully a couple of these projects going on. So that's primarily a quick snapshot of the role of the account executive or sales engineer. So, and I'll just give you this. If you're new to the industry and you're graduating college, I'm going to tell you this too. Like, try to find an office you can go visit for a day. Most people, if you call them up and say, hey, I'm an engineer, I'm graduating soon, I don't know anything about this job, do you mind if I come hang out for a day? Most people I know, including myself, I would love to have that opportunity. I would think that's great. So don't be afraid to pick up the phone and ask somebody. If the first person you call won't let you, try another guy. Try to get an intern if you can. That's another piece of advice I'd tell you. And I would tell you too, talk to other industries, look at other jobs, because, you know, the last thing you want to do, you know, I've been, you know, working for a couple of years now. The last thing you want to do is take a job out of fear, or a job that you think you should take because someone else wants you to, but it's not really, you know, doesn't really jive with what you want to do. You know, don't do that, because you got to work for a lot of years and you got to work for a lot of time during those years. So make sure you do something that jives with your values, what's in your heart, and something you want to do for the long run, because, you know, choosing the wrong job and sticking with it for a long time could not be a lot of fun. So anyway, I hope that helps. I hope that this HVAC podcast is helping somebody out there who hears this. My email's in the description. You could find it on our website too, insightusa.com. That's insightusa.com. You know, look me up there if you have questions. You could always email me. And I would also like to say thank you all so much for your support of the podcast. It's been tons of fun, and we love being able to give back. So thank you all so much, and hope you have a great day. So as we close this podcast, I just want to give a huge shout out to the people that take the time to leave reviews of this podcast on Apple and Spotify and all the other platforms. It just means the world to me that you take that extra 13 to 95 seconds to show your appreciation and also give context to the people as to why this is a worthwhile podcast. So I appreciate that so much. I hope to catch you on the next one. And thanks so much for listening.